when the active genes are there, when active genes are present, what are active genes? Active genes are those genes which are involved in the process of transcription. When active genes are present, these are called euchromatin, and these are mostly present in a widened DNA molecule. These are present in a widened DNA molecule. If the DNA is coming close together with the help of these histone molecules, these are not active genes, these are sleeping genes. They are sleeping genes, they do not undergo the process of transcription. They are, as this is widened DNA, this is closed DNA. They are present inside a closed DNA molecule. These are euchromatin, this is heterochromatin. So these genes are very important. We need this DNA molecule to move apart. How it is moved apart? By bringing up this acetyl molecule. When you bring up this acetyl molecule, the histone molecule goes further away. When the histone molecule goes further, the DNA is widened up. The genes are now able to transcript. When these are able to transcript, this is called euchromatin. And this euchromatin contains of active genes. And active genes contains of widened genes. They are present in the widened DNA. Besides this RNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3, there are other factors which are TF. The TF means transcription factors. These are transcription factors. Transcription factors are very important for this RNA polymerase to function. Whenever this transcription factor will not be there, RNA polymerase won't be acting. So transcription factor, how they are named? They are named transcription factor 2. Why 2? Because it is RNA polymerase 2. Transcription factor 1. Why 1? Because it contains RNA polymerase 1. Why 3? Transcription factor 3, because they are helping RNA polymerase 3. So transcription factor 1, 2 and 3, because it depends on different RNA polymerases. Whatever it act on RNA polymerase 1, so it will be 1. It has RNA polymerase 2, so it will be transcription factor 2. And if it is 7, transcription factor 3, so it will be transcription factor 3. So now coming to transcription factor 2. It is a further different types like type A, B, D, H. So there are different types. Depending on their function, there are different types. Now we come up to the another very quick diagram. These are polymerases, RNA polymerase 1, which form one form of RNA, RNA polymerase 2, which form another form of RNA, RNA polymerase 3, which form another part of RNA. So we know RNA polymerase 1, which helps RNA ribosomal RNA, RNA polymerase 2, which helps you to form messenger RNA. This we have already discussed, protein at the promoter site. So this is minus 39 position, this was the primer box. Point 1 plus 1 is start of the synthesis of RNA in a prokaryotic organism. If we talk about the eukaryotic organism, so eukaryotic organism, this is point of replication. So there was a primer box at position number minus 10. There is at position number minus 25, there is another sort of box. The name of this box is Tata box or a Hogdix box. And this, when you further go up the stream, there is another box, scat box. Sometimes it is present and sometimes it is not present. This Tata box, it can be present sometimes, it cannot be present sometimes. If it is present or if it is not present, there are other very important parts, of the DNA which help us for the process of transcription. And those are present from minus 2 upstream to plus 4. And this is DPE, downstream co-promoter. If you look at downstream co-promoter, the positive signs, here will the process of initiation will be taking place because here will be point 1 somewhere. And here is plus sign, so plus sign is downstream. When you go up the stream, so this is up the stream on this side, and this side it is downstream. So Tata box can be there, a cat box can be there, an initiator side can be there, and DPE, downstream co-promoter element, all of these can be present in the DNA molecule, and there will be the attachment of RNA polymerase.